Hey, baby, I hear the blues are calling. Toss salads and scrambled eggs. Today, the city of goodwill, the Emerald State. Thank you so much for having me here as I campaign today to become President of the United States of America. What a beautiful location up here in the Puget Sound where all my marine mammal friends live. All those wonderful seals and dolphins and orcas. Okay, screw the orcas! Nope, they can all go to hell! The big reason why I am campaigning here today is the mass abundance of wonderful seafood! I mean, just look at the smorgasbord of all the wonderful seafood that lives here in the oceans in Seattle! We've got all the wonderful herring and salmon and mussels, squid, Dungeness crab, and of course, my favorite... Clams! Clams are everything in life! Seattle, you get a 10 out of 10 on the seafood scale! Give yourself a round of applause! Yay! So, it is known to rain quite a bit here. But that's okay. With Mount Rainier just a few hours away, you have the trees, the ocean, and it's just super pretty out here! Let's go for a nice walk in nature! Wow! With such beautiful conditions, lichen can grow on all of these trees in the temperate rainforest. And these conditions make it amazing for creatures like bobcats and beavers to live here, as well as... Sasquatch! Okay, so apparently Sasquatch lives out here too. So, that's why now I'm safe and sound here along the seashore. Seattle is a port city where lots of goods can be shipped across the ocean, especially if most of those goods are based around seafood. Now, let's see what creatures are swimming in the ocean right now. The Kraken! What is this, Seattle? Is this just a place where mythological creatures live? Well, those creatures are not gonna get me from up here, cause I am about 14,000 feet at the top of Mount Rainier. Look how scenic it is from up here. And this place goes over 100 square miles too. This mountain is freaking ginormous! And that's not my stomach. And now it's a volcano! Well, I'm done being with nature. Everything is trying to kill me. So why don't we just go out and catch a game? We could go see the... No. Well, why don't we just have a beer instead? We could have a... Oh, get Seattle. And might as well just hang out here and wait for my impending doom. I could at least go see a football game, could go cheer on the Seahawks. I could also go cheer on the Mariners. There's plenty of fun things to do for nightlife around here as well. While it's pretty cool that the Space Needle was built for the 1962 World's Fair, it's such an expensive tourist trap with a stupid long line. And I'm waiting! Instead, go next door to the Museum of Pop Culture, where you can see all sorts of cool stuff from fantasy to costume design, and you can even play your own instruments. Plus, you can see the official exhibits for two of the best musicians of all time, Jimi Hendrix and Nirvana! Hendrix was a guitar god! And Nirvana made flannel and sarcasm popular all across the country in the 1990s. And yeah, Nirvana, yeah, they're just some band. I think they were kind of big, I guess. Whatever, man. Like, I'm running for president, I think, because the system is just dumb. Plus, they were able to make a living off yelling the same words over and over that nobody could understand. You can also do the underground tour and learn how the city kept having sewer issues, so a giant avalanche of poop kept flooding the entire city again and again and again. It's quite amazing how the original designs for the plumbing of Seattle were quite crafty. And of course, what trip to Seattle would be complete without checking out the Pike Place Market? Besides all the delicious seafood, you can buy your produce, flowers, crafts, and even have a beer on the pier. And my favorite thing is when they fly the fish overhead. Look at that, that's pretty cool there. Hey, buddy, can you toss one down my gullet? Pike Place is also the home of the original Starbucks. However, it just looks like any ordinary Starbucks. What you want to do is go a few blocks away to the roastery. Well, look, there was a lot of caffeine in that coffee. Oh my god. Maybe I should get some of this area's nice rocky tobacco to mellow me out. You know, they call the city Seattle, but I don't see any auto. So now that I have seen your bluish-green city of rain and grunge, here are five things I will do to represent Seattle when I am President of the United States. Number one, a neighborhood watch for volcanoes and mythical creatures. No matter where you go, you could be Sasquatch Town in the forest, your boat could turn into the Kraken's rubber ducky, or you could be like Miss Frizzle and raft a river of lava down Mount Rainier. So in that case, we will have rangers stationed all over the Seattle area at all times to alert anyone of dangerous activity. All insurance companies in the Seattle region will be required by federal law to offer volcano, Sasquatch, and Kraken insurance.
Protect yourself from mayhem, like me.
Number two. National Grunge Day on April 5th to commemorate Kurt Cobain and Layne Staley. I will create a new federal holiday known as National Grunge Day. Flannel, sarcasm, and messing on the job will all be encouraged. School assemblies and office board meetings will actually be exciting for once. The federal government is not responsible for any injuries that may occur. Number three, the Space Needle will get a fun swing. I mean, think about it. If you're gonna stand there and wait in line, you might as well get bang for your buck. Plus, we'll provide free umbrellas for anyone waiting in line down below in case someone up above barfs on you. Coming 2024. Number four, orcas will be offered a seafood buffet so they will stop eating sea otters. In order to save the sea otters, the government will set up a gigantic seafood buffet along the Seattle coastline where orcas can eat all that they want and leave the sea otters alone. Because sea otters are so cute. And orcas are giant oversized soccer water pandas. Blah! And number five, a giant statue of a toilet to honor the brave city construction workers who were able to hold off millions of gallons of poo. A giant toilet will be built along the shoreline. Not only that, but it will be fully functional. That's right. So if Sasquatch decides to invade and he needs to go number two, he knows exactly where to go. This city has survived pants pudding mudslides before, and it can do it again! Thank you so much, Seattle, for having me. You have been awesome! Well, actually a lot of you have been really sarcastic, so in that case... And then I guess you guys can vote for me or something. That would be kind of cool. Thank you. I don't want to have to work too much. Anyway, there's some like and subscribe buttons down there. There's a few other videos that I've made. Please support me. And don't forget that humans are trash. Bye bye, Seattle.